Good morning, students. Last time we had done the various weighing methods to find out the loss of water by transpiration. Today we are going to study about the potometers. Potometers are of various types designed by various scientists to study and measure the rate of transpiration, namely the farmer's potometer and Genong's potometer, which helps to measure the rate of water intake by the plant. And another potometer is Darwin's potometer, which helps to demonstrate the suction force created due to transpiration. When water is lost by the plant due to transpiration, then a suction force is set up which pulls the water up in the xylem vessels. Then Garrow's potometer, which demonstrate unequal transpiration from the two surfaces of dorsiventral leaf. What is a dorsiventral leaf? Dorsiventral leaf is a leaf which is horizontally arranged on the stem, and it has the upper surface and the lower surface, and that upper surface has less stomata on it and the lower surface has more stomata. So more of the water is lost by transpiration from the lower surface of the leaf as compared to the upper surface. Then Genong's potometer. In this is Genong's potometer, and a twig of suitable plant Secolius is introduced into it, and we cut this twig with a sharp knife and we fix it in the apparatus, make the apparatus airtight, and the entire apparatus is filled with water and no air space is present in it. And now the air bubble is introduced into this apparatus. This is introduced by lifting up this tube above the water in the beaker, and when air enters, immediately we put this tube down into the beaker containing colored water. The air bubble travels in the capillary tube due to the suction force set up by the twig. And the transpiration proceeds. That is, as water is lost from this twig, a suction force is set up and that pulls the water from the beaker. And when this water is pulled up from the beaker, the air bubble, which was initially at zero, starts moving on this graduated tube, and we can measure the loss of water, or we can say we can measure the uptake of water by the cut chute. Why do we say uptake of water by the cut chute? Because it will measure the water which is taken up by the cut chute, and we usually say it that it is equal to the amount of water lost by transpiration, because 98% of that water which is taken up by the chute is lost by transpiration. And again, if you want to bring this bubble back to its initial position, we open the stopcock and let the water enter into the apparatus through the reservoir. So potometer do not measure the water lost during transpiration, but measures the water uptake by the cut chute. And some of the water is used up by the cells to carry out other processes, for example, manufacture of food, that is photosynthesis. Now, certain precautions we have to take while using this potometer. This potometer should be completely watertight. No leakage of water should be there from any part. Then the twig should be cut obliquely. We should not just cut it horizontally. We should give it a slant cut so as to allow larger surface of the water intake. And underwater, we should cut it underwater so that the air bubble into the twig, which will stop the absorption of water into the xylem, should not enter. So three precautions should be taken. One is that the apparatus should be watertight. Another, the shoot should be cut obliquely so as to provide larger surface area for the water intake. Second, the shoot should be cut underwater so that the air bubble may not enter into the twig, and that will stop the absorption of water into the xylem. Then there are limitations in the use of potometer. This introducing of the air bubble through this end is not easy, and the twig may not remain fully alive for a long time. It is a soft, delicate twig, so it may not live for a long time. And any changes in the outside air temperature may affect the position of the air bubble in the capillary tube. So if there is any change in the temperature outside, that also will affect the position of air bubble in the capillary tube. So this much for today.